And so there are two things that you should do right now to help your child. Hey, good optometry morning. So your child or grandchild could be at risk for losing their vision as an adult, but there is something that you can do right now and be the hero to prevent that. So today I'm going to be your guide to talk to you about the eye disease of myopia and the things that you can do to prevent your child or grandchild from losing their vision as an adult. Hey, I'm Dr. Michael Nelson, YouTube Eye Doctor, and as a parent or grandparent, you want to do everything you can to protect your child's vision. And if you can, you want to help make sure that they have healthy eyesight even when they're an adult. So a lot of people don't know this, but there is something that you can do when your child is 5, 6, 7, or 8 years old that might help reduce the risk significantly of them having poor vision in their 40s, 50s, 60s, and 70s. It is unbelievable. But the key is, you can't delay, and you need to act right now. So today I'm going to give you the tools and the knowledge to help you be an early adopter and the hero and protect your child against the eye disease of myopia. So many people think that myopia is just nearsightedness and it's just this eye condition that you correct with glasses or contact lenses. That's what we thought once, but that's not true anymore. We now know that myopia is an eye disease, and it can cause significant risk for vision loss when an adult. People with high myopia have a 5 times increased risk of developing cataracts, 14 times increased risk of glaucoma, a 22% increase of developing retinal detachments, and a whopping 41 times likelihood that you'll develop myopic macular degeneration as an adult. Those figures are incredible, and if you can help reduce that, you gotta act. All right, before we go any further, you need to know 3 terms. So these are the terms that we use to describe the refractive error or the prescription or how things are focused in the eye. So the 3 terms are emmetropia, hyperopia, and myopia. So emmetropia is a condition when light rays are focused perfectly on the macula or the back of the retina. And if this is the case, you'll have an eyeglass prescription of 0 and you will not need any glasses to help you see far away. Hyperopia is when the light rays are not focused on the retina, but they're actually focused behind the retina. And if you have this, your eyeglass prescription will have a plus sign in front of it. And myopia is when the light rays are focused in front of the retina. And if you're myopic, your prescription is going to have a minus sign in front of it. So the other thing that we'll do with myopia is we'll often categorize it as different severity. So basically, low myopia is any prescription that's basically between 0 and -3. Moderate myopia is any prescription between about -3 and -6. And high myopia is considered any prescription over -6 diopters. One thing that a lot of people don't know is that when we are born, we are actually all born hyperopic. And the average newborn prescription is about +2 diopters. And as we grow and as the eyeball grows, slowly the eyeball will grow and move to where those light rays are focused, and that newborn and infant will slowly become less hyperopic as they get older. And this process is called emmetropatization.
Emmetropization.
And it's the process of normal growth towards no prescription or emmetropia. Now, most children reach emmetropia or 0 prescription around the ages between 3 and 6 years old. And if everything goes normally, everything will stay right there and they won't develop any prescription further on. But some kids, for one reason or another, their eyeball will keep growing. And as it keeps growing, the eyeball moves away from the light where the light rays are focused, and the child becomes more and more myopic. And this process of becoming myopic is not normal. There's no normal amount of myopia. Our eyes are designed to be emmetropic. And so when you're developing this myopia, this is a disease process that's going on inside the eye. And the real problem with myopia is basically the eyeball's growing too large, and that increased growth will cause stretching of all the retinal tissues inside your eye. Because basically everyone's given the same amount of retinal tissue. That's the tissue that lines the inside of the eyeball. And so if your eyeball's bigger than mine is, that means that that retina tissue is stretched over a larger surface area than mine is. And those stretching forces inside the eye are causing the risk for eye disease as an adult. All right, so I'm going to get into what you need to do right now. But if you've learned anything new in this video so far, make sure you hit the like button down below so you can let YouTube know the value of this video. And if you happen to wear glasses, write a comment about when you first got glasses. So most people are familiar with myopia as being basically a situation when you can't see things far away and things are blurry. And that's really important. So it's important to make sure that you can get that corrected so you can see clearer. But preventing the growth of the eye to develop those extreme stretching forces particularly for people who are high myopes, is really important. And so in the past, when I was a child, and probably when you were a child as well, there wasn't really anything we could do to slow down and prevent the progression of myopia, but that's not true anymore. There are things we can do to slow down and significantly reduce the growth of the eyeball and the progression of the myopia. And so there are two things that you should do right now to help your child. Number one, you need to make sure your child has an eye exam with your optometrist at least every year, and look for even the smallest amount of myopia developing. And by measuring the length of the eyeball and comparing to normal growth curves of other kids, we can predict that a child's going to become highly myopic even before they reach the state of ametropia, even when they're a little bit hyperopic still. And then what you want to do is make sure you're having a conversation with your optometrist about myopia management, about the things that you can do right now and in the future to help reduce the risk of them becoming more myopic or even myopic in the first place. And so the other thing that you need to do is you need to learn about the things that are causing the myopia to develop in the first place. And to learn about that, you should be watching this video right here. And with that, have a great optometry day.